Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. I welcome all the engineering students, especially the students of Khwaja Farid University of Engineering and Information Technology. Dear students, in the previous lecture, we have discussed the angular momentum and the change in angular momentum and the rate of change of angular momentum. The change in angular momentum is basically the angular impulse, and the rate of change of angular momentum is basically the moment. I have given all the theory, the formulae, and also solved 3 to 4 sample problems. Today, I solve the unsolved problem of the same topic. So let's move to the angular impulse and angular momentum unsolved problems. So first problem is 3-215. Determine the magnitude of H naught as angular momentum of the angle of the 2 kilogram sphere about point O. The first is requirement is to find the angular momentum by using the vector method, and then find the same moment again using the scalar method. So for the vector methods R cross F, so this is R cross the linear momentum R cross MB. So B, it can be divided into two components, 7 cos of 45 I, 7 sine of 45 J, and similarly R is 12 I plus 5 J. So I move here. So mass is 2 kilogram, H naught is equal to R cross MB. So R is 12 I plus 5 J, and the velocity is 7 cos of 45 I plus 7 sine of 45 J. So please, then I take the cross product, so I into IJ and I into J, according to this rule, circular rule, I into J, and the K is coming the same direction as a positive. When I take J into cross I, it is minus of K, and then of course J cross J is 0. I get 69.3 Newton meter per second is the angular momentum in the K direction. Now, by the scalar method, of course, the moment in the X direction is 2 into 7 cos of 45, 9.89 Newton second. Similarly, Y is 9.89 Newton seconds. So this X will, and this is the arm of force, this X will provide the moment in the clockwise direction. So it is 7 cos of 45 into 5, right? This is negative, and of course I'm taking counterclockwise positive. Similarly, 12 into 9.89, this is 12, and this is the x-axis arm of force. So it rotate in the counterclockwise direction. We get the same result, 69.3 Newton meter per second in the anticlockwise direction. The assembly starts from rest, problem 3-123, and reaches an angular speed of 150 revolutions per minute under the action of the 20 Newton force T applied to the string for T seconds. We need to find what is the time taken to get this velocity by 3 kilogram spheres. Dear students, the initial momentum, the angular momentum plus the impulse is equal to final angular momentum. So initial angular momentum is 0 because initially it is at rest. Now T1 to T2 is the impulse for some small period of time. The moment is 20. This 20 is the force into arm of force 0.1 multiplied by T, I don't know. Then there is a moment MV. Sorry, this is the mass M, and this, and the velocity is of course V. This is this velocity is 4 meters per second, 3 kilogram sphere, and this is the force is 20 Newton, is a 150 revolutions per minute. So I convert this one, this this 3 is the mass of 1, and 4 is the mass of 3 is the mass of 1, and there is a 4 sphere, this becomes 4 into 3, and this MR, right, MVRV, so M, this is M, right, then I have a velocity is equal to R omega. So please, R omega into R, therefore is 0.4 square. 150 revolutions per minute multiplied by 2 pi by 60, we get revolutions per second, and the time taken is 15.08 seconds taken to reach the, of course, the RPM of 150 revolutions per minute when the force applied is, of course, T is 20 newtons. Now let's move to problem 3-25. A small 4-ounce particle is subjected with a horizontal velocity of 6 feet per second into the top A of the smooth circular guide fixed in the vertical vane. In the fixed vertical vane, we start, drop it here, it moves from B and then reaches to C. Calculate the time rate of change of angular momentum about point O, about this point B, when the particle reaches the bottom of the guide at C. So initial velocity is 6 feet per second, and then it moves from A to B and then B to C. So remember that here the change in kinetic energy is equal to the change in potential energy. So initial kinetic energy is half mba square plus mgh from A to C is the change in potential energy is equal to half mbc square. So mass and mass cancel out. I get bc square is equal to va square plus hac. So dear students, from here I can easily write it. It is vc square is equal to va square plus 32.2. And this m is 20.12 into the the height change. Height change is 10 and 10 this, and this m, this is the 32.2. Yes, this is the mass. I converted in this mass because it is of only point, how many ounce please? 4 ounce. 4 ounce is equal to 1 pound. So it's 32.2, right? So 32.2 20 by 12 into 2. We get Vc is equal to 143.3 feet square per second square. Now, this way, here, we need to find a change momentum. So it is, this is the normal reaction, this is the weight. So summation of all the forces, N minus the weight is equal to M. This is the acceleration, centripetal acceleration, your normal acceleration, V square upon R. This is V square, this is a rho, 10 upon 12. From here, I can find the normal reaction. Now, the moment is equal to the rate of change of angular momentum. So moment produced by the net force, this is 1.585, and this is minus 0.5, and this arm of force is 10 inches 10 by 12, and we get 1.13 k foot pound is a change in a rate of change of angular momentum, or which is equal to moment about point B, right? And this is a point is 10 inches. Let's move to problem 3-238 from the 6th edition. Each of the 4 spheres of mass M is treated as a particle. Sphere A and B are mounted on a light rod and are rotating initially with an angular velocity omega naught about a vertical axis through O. Sphere C and D are also mounted on the light rod, which is pivoted independently about O and is initially at rest. Assembly AB contacts CD in slot A. In A and B allow engagement and latching to CD in the dash position shown. Both units then rotate with a common angular velocity omega frictionless, determine the expression omega and percentage loss of kinetic energy. So dear students, how these are the A, B, C and D having equal masses and rotating like this. So for the entire system, initial momentum is equal to final momentum. So it is 2mr square omega naught square is equal, and the other moment is 0, 2mr square omega plus 2m2r square omega. We just simplify this, we get omega is 2 omega naught by 10, which is omega naught by 5, please correct it. Kinetic energy loss, delta Q is T1 minus T2. So initially there are two masses, half mr square minus, and then of course the total mass of the two, that when they stick together, we get this energy, and this energy we get it about simplify, we get delta Q 4 by 5 mr square mega square. Percentage loss, we just divide with the initial mass, the kinetic energy, is about 80% loss in the energy. Again, problem, two spheres of equal mass M are able to slide along the horizontal rotating rod if they are initially latched in position a distance r from the rotating axis, with the assembly rotating freely with an angular velocity omega naught. Determine the new angular velocity omega after the spheres are released, and finally assume position at the ends of the rod at the radial distance 2r. Also find the fraction. Neglect the small changes. Dear student, these are the bobs which is sliding over this initially at their R position. When they reach at the 2R position, this is the final position. So of course, 2MR R naught R, delta H is equal to final momentum. This is the initial momentum, 2M2R omega times 2R. Right? This is initially moving with the angular velocity omega naught. So this is M, this is M, so it becomes 2M, and R omega is the velocity, this is R, R is the moment, right? Similarly, minus this moment, because 2M, it is at 2R position, right? Sorry, at 2R, right? This is 2MR, and this is a velocity, omega R. Here R is 2R. We simplify omega is equal to omega naught by 4. The kinetic energy initially is 2 half mv square, because of two masses, minus the velocity after this is again 2 half m, and this is the velocity. So this velocity is of course omega naught by 4 whole square. Velocity is r omega square, so it is 2 r omega square. This r omega, omega is this one. You simplify, of course, this 2 and 2 cancel, this becomes 4, this becomes 16, this becomes r omega square by 4. The final is 3 m r omega square by 4. The reduction in energy is delta T by original energy. Original energy, you know that it is 2 half m r omega square, this is m r omega square. I put the value, I get 3 by 4, which is 75% is the reduction in the kinetic energy after the rotation, when the masses move apart to a distance of 2 r, when it is moving with the angular velocity of omega. Problem 3-230, a small 0.1 kilogram particle is given in a velocity of 2 meter per second on the horizontal xy plane and is guided by the fixed curve rail. Friction is negligible as the particle crosses the y axis at A. Its velocity is in the x direction and it crosses the x axis at B. Its velocity makes an angle 60 degree with the x axis. The radius of curvature of the path at B is 500 millimeter. Determine the time rate of change of the angular momentum h naught of the particle about the z axis through O at both A and B. So this is A, and then it is at B, velocity rate of change at B. So it is moving from here to here. So when it reaches at point here, this is the normal reaction from the of the this surface, right? And this is the velocity direction, and if I extend it here, this is the arm of force, which is B, right? Which is B, and this B is, I can find out by taking the right hand, right triangle, this hypotenuse square, is equal to perpendicular square of base square. I can find this one. So moment about z, special moment about z, is basically rate of change of angular momentum. Let's see at A. Special moment about z is zero because this is passing through the origin. So at origin it is zero. So therefore there is rate of change of momentum is also zero. At B, at this point, now the special moment about z is minus this here, because it rotated in the clockwise direction, minus nb times this b distance, where nb, what is nb? Nb is equal to nb is equal to mv square, v square, which is rotating, so it is mass r square by rho, which is the centripetal acceleration or normal acceleration. This nb becomes of course 0.8 newtons. So h dot naught, the rate of change of angular momentum about O in the z direction, is minus nbv, minus 0.8 into 0.150, 0.120 newton meter, or minus 0.10 kilogram meter square per second square. So this is the rate of change of angular momentum, which is gives you the moment at of this B about point O in the z direction. The problem 3-238, the assembly of the 2 5 kilogram spheres is rotating freely about the vertical axis at 40 revolutions per minute with theta is equal to 90 degree. If the force F, which maintains the given position, is increased to raise the base collar and reduce theta to 60 degree, determine the new angular velocity omega. Also determine the work U done by F in changing the configuration of the system. Assume that the mass of the arm and collar is negligible. This is the mechanism. These two bobs with a 5 kilogram, because of this structure, they are maintained at a common at a fixed distance, and it is rotating about this axis. This axis is off shift by 100 millimeter. This total, this is 300 millimeter, and this is 300 millimeter. Total arm is 300. This is also 300, and this is right I can say isosceles triangle. But this distance is 100 millimeter, and the force is applied here. It will move in upward and downward direction because of the rotation. We are interested, but we have to be interested to find the new angular velocity and also the work done in moving this collar up and down. Dear student, first of all, omega naught, which is rotating, 40 revolutions per minute, so 40 into 2 pi by 60, it becomes 4.19 radians per second. This distance A, I say it is only 0.1 meter, and this distance B, where this distance B, which is 0.3 meter, I say B this one. This is 0.3 meter. For theta is equal to 90 degree, which theta, this angle is 90 degree. For theta is equal to 90 degree, so R naught is equal to So R naught is equal to 0.1 plus 2 times of 0.3 cos of 45. Right? This is 2 times because 300 and 300. So the theta is equal to this arm of force. I'm saying this distance. So this distance will be equal to this 600 into cos of 45. This angle is theta, this is 45, 45. Right? So we get total arm of force. This is R naught of this bob is 5.524 meters. When theta is equal to 60 degree, of course, just change the value here. This is cos of 60, which is, cos of 60 or 30. Can you find out this one? Because 60 degrees, cos of 60 is 0.5, and we get 0.62 meters. Now, the change of linear momentum is equal to delta H is equal to 0. So the initial momentum is, of course, 2m, because these two masses are equal, 2m r naught omega naught initial radius, and then minus 2m r square omega is equal to 0 when angle is 90 and when angle is 60. So it's 2m is cancelled out. We have omega is equal to r naught square by r square omega naught. So this is my r naught and this is my r at 60 degree. So I get the value of omega, which is 3 radian per second, or I can say revolution 60 by 2 pi, 28.6 revolutions per minute. Now, dear student, we also interested the work done. The work done here is basically change in kinetic energy plus change in gravitational potential energy. So change in kinetic energy is a half m, twice is the two masses, r naught square omega square minus r naught square omega naught square plus 2mgh. Where, what is h here? So h is I can show you here, this h is this much. This h is, well, this angle is 45, initially the h is 0.3 sine of 45, and this is because 2b, because this length is b plus b 2b, and then it becomes minus 2b sine of 30 degree, or sine of 30 degree, half of the angle, and we simplify it is 0.1243 delta h. So just put the value here, u is equal to 2 to cancel out. This becomes mass, which is 5, r is square omega square, right? Minus r naught square omega naught whole square plus 2m, this is g, this is h, and this I simplify to get 5.34 joule of work is done by moving this summary upward. Now, dear students, this completes the angular momentum and angular impulse, and of course the rate of change of angular momentum, which is called moment. There may be one or two more lectures on this, and this course will be completed. I will let you know by Sunday by Monday what is the course included in the final exam. But you have to do all these questions, not only this, from the book. First of all, see the video and take the lecture, solve the problem which I have solved by hand. Understand it and then solve some more problem from your book, and then things will be understandable for you. Any question, you can contact me.